Hello, this is Alpha, and welcome back to my play-by-email versus Joachim Haydn. Now, we're going to be watching the combat replay for December 17th, 1941. Big event's going to be this. We should cross over into Singapore, so we will see whether or not we take it. Other than that, not much going on. You know, sub-warfare and maneuvering in China. So let's see what we got. All right. So we see 1, 2, 3 subs off the coast of Japan already. He is not wasting any time. All right, Waitland switches, so that opens the railroad there. That's nice. We almost got the railroad all the way to Hankow open, so that's looking good. Sweeping mines, 14, 15. About 3 there. Really? How can you miss that big ass fucking tanker? Shot 6 torpedoes at that tanker and not one hit. And we got something coming out of Sorbeha. Shangho, that's one of the ones I think that comes out of Hong Kong. Alright, we take a hit there. And 18 more mines, 18 more mines, about 36 more mines. Trying to clear out the mines as soon as possible. We can get 38th over. Yep, that can. AKA, we knew that was on fire, finally burnt up, hopefully, we got some more supply off of it. Fortunately, anything catches fire that has supply in the Japanese Navy is like guaranteed to burn up. It's just gonna go. Yeah, I doubt there's a ship in Wen Chow. All right, 20 more, 21 more. Okay, and destroy 2, 3, 24 mine. Man, that's a lot of mines. I don't remember Hong Kong having this many mines and taking this long to sweep them. Jesus. Alright, Argonauts had a shot at an AKL and decided not to. We'll take that. Now you're in shallow water. This should be pretty good damage here. And misses, but taking some water. Misses, somebody taking on some water. Hit, side penetrated, very nice. Severe damage and taking on water, we'll take that. Okay, well, it says we got 7 hits. We just saw a lot of near misses with some water, but that we had one good hit. More mines being swept. And... ooh, I-171 scores. So... yep, okay. I think that's the first one for that. That's pretty far south. I wonder if you're going to go farther south. So we got a whole line of picket ships, like, basically all through here between Akatuni and Pago Pago. So that's going to go down. Yep. We're trying to make them go even farther, and then we'll put subs in front of New Zealand if he goes back in there, and then subs in front of Oz. Those are on the way. So, but these are probably all heading back to the West Coast to start transporting things. The death subs are off to Cal and Taiwan again, or Formosa at this time period. Let's kind of fast forward it through these detections. Alright, bombing Clark again. We had a couple of bad days of weather, so we didn't get to do much damage, so we need to get that damage back up. bombing these guys in the mountain. They actually do a decent amount of damage. So, those probably gonna be switched over next turn. It's very nice, very nice. Gotta get these guys damaged and clear terrain as much as possible. This is basically a practice run. The Sonyas don't really have range to anything that's not in heavy cover. Those are probably gonna be upgraded to Nyx here shortly. We're bombing Tumulo Airfield just to kind of keep them from building up any airfield or fortifications there too. Another bombing raid at Tumulo. Alright, I-7. Well, so you wasted 6 in the first attack and another 4. That went 10 torpedoes that he just wasted and didn't get a damn thing for it. So we landed at Kivyang, we just short of Rabaul. We'll probably land there next turn. And that's going to be it for the air phase. And now moving into Lanet. So our shock attack is Singapore. Now we have 3 divisions in a tank regiment and a couple of engineers with artillery. He doesn't have much to hold us, but it is, I don't think he has a fort there. Destroying a couple units, and we capture Singapore. Hello, so, December 17th, 1941, we managed to take these guys. So, it's going to be a pretty good amount of forces and points. We'll take that. Alright, so. We've got a Blenheim on the ground. Everything else has already made it out of here. So we took about 1,350 casualties, but only 3 squads, 4 squads destroyed, the rest are disabled. Those will be kind of rebuilt, hopefully fairly quick, but for 18,475. So 179 combat squads, 2,076 non-combat, 40 engineers, 312 guns, 128 vehicles, 19 units are destroyed. Very nice, very nice. All right, I don't know what happened here, but our 2nd Regiment tanks decided to cross over into Tumulo without the 265th Brigade, so that's kind of weird. He does have about 97 AV there. We rolled obviously really bad because, well, yeah. But we only lose 8 vehicles, and we inflict pretty decent casualties. So, I don't know why, because it was on follow, and it had been following, and then suddenly it changed its mind. So, I don't know. But luckily it didn't turn out too bad for us. We bounce again at Monado, but we did reduce the fortifications to level 0. We got some fatigue, so we're going to waste wait a turn. We might send a bombardment force. I don't want to bombard here because I want to be able to use the airfield pretty quick. So, yeah, that's it for the turn. Obviously, Singapore is very good. We'll have to move some minesweepers into there. And then we will start clearing those mines. And then one of the divisions is going to be there for at least a few weeks, if not a month, rebuilding. The one that took all the disablements. But the other 2 divisions are at full power or full strength. They're able to do their thing. And then we're going to continue up with our rest of our operations here. So let's take a look at the aircraft losses for this turn. So 1-5, we took 2 Sallys for op losses, 2 Vals for op losses, 1 Sally 2A for an op loss. We took 5 op losses. We're losing a lot in op losses, unfortunately. It's just part of that. We are now up to 40 points of army losses to only 7 of ours. We're now up claiming 103 ally ships for only 500 points. Last turn, we're going to lose that AK, which unfortunately was a decent sized one, so it's 12 points. The one we sank is only 8 points, but we get all the motor launches that were being built at Singapore, which puts us ahead for shipping last turn. So let's go ahead and take a look at Singapore. Yes, the 56th div is going to take a little while to rebuild these guys, but other than that, the other 2, like I said, are still sitting at 430 and 421 respectively. Which, you know, by the time we clear the mines and everything like this, these guys should be up to pretty much full strength. And I think 50 is almost, yeah. So again, we should get these guys almost completely up to full strength. To be fair, these are the better ones. 5th Div is 91 experience, 91.3 morale. 18th Div is 85, 86. 56, I believe, was a little bit of our weaker one. So 66 and 89. So you can tell that's the one that took the brunt of the damage. Meanwhile, we will probably send the tank unit up to Malacca. Yeah, we'll probably send that, and then we'll start setting up for the rest of these guys to travel somewhere else. I believe... First of all, yeah, 21st Div is on the way. Our other divisions are on the way. Setting up for Singapore for invasion of Java. We're still clearing the mines at Hong Kong, but we at least got at least another turn for these APs and that to get there anyway, so it's not that big of a loss. The biggest thing that I noticed this turn that's going to be of interest is this. He's moving south to Nanyang to try to rescue these guys, which I think is a huge mistake. Now, he does have like 190,000 troops here. He's probably got a good 4K, maybe-ish, AV here. If he moves south with the whole thing, this could be bad. But we actually have a decent amount of AV here. We have three complete divisions, a tank regiment and armored car regiment here for 1,276 AV. I also have another division and a tank regiment here. So we could very well do a lot of damage here. I think he's making a mistake there. Unfortunately, 35th is another day out. So this thing's unpacking two. They're about 5 days from being able to affect this, so I don't think they're going to be much use there. I think, let's see, technically you are on this turn, so you're about 2 days to here. We're making some headway, so we might be able to do pretty good amount of damage, and then obviously he's just pulling out ahead of us here. We're trying to catch up to him. With we got, you know, about 1200 AV here plus another 161 worth of tanks on the way, and then another two divisions here, so another 800. So we got about 2200 AV moving north to Siam to try to cut these guys off. We'll see how this plays out. I like to do a lot of damage here, try to trap these guys somewhere into here, and I really want to break off of a couple forces to go try to go north to Nanyang, or not Nanyang, because we see absolutely nothing here holding this line. So we can push up to here, take Nanyang, where we can use that, and then cross over the mountains, or even get up into farther cut off here and surround these guys. This is my goal. I want the pincer movement. I want to take go behind here with the tanks and the AV, take Siam behind him. I want to move forces to Nanyang to cut over through here to surround these 190,000 troops. That is our initial plan, is to take Siam and cut these guys off. And then if we can break into the Chongqing plain, that's all the better. Our subs, I-7 is pretty much going to be probably out of fucking torpedoes. Yeah, he's used half his torpedoes on that, which really sucks. We're sending one this way and one south to see if we can catch up and take another shot at these tankers. These guys will be heading back in. I try to also see if I can catch those other tankers or groups that we saw last time we did it. So these guys will be heading back in. We'll put like one here, like we have like a little ring of steel around Los Angeles, San Diego. We have this guy going to move a little bit farther in. He's spotting to see if he starts sending things out of San Francisco. And we have one up here to see if he's moving out of Seattle. We haven't seen anything out of Hawaii. So I think I pulled off one of these subs again to head north. And then down here, we got two subs in position. We got another sub or two subs heading down here to finish our kind of like picket line here. Like we're every two... three spots will have a sub, and plus we have I-10 is a Glenn sub, so hopefully he can spot things and then vector other people in. And then Kittipitai is well spotted. So yeah. But they're doing their job. These guys will be, once these guys get these third landings done, we got our fast task forces. Once we get all these guys done, we'll probably maybe head south just to see how we're looking over here. I think I pulled this guy out to cover the other side of Noumea. I need to get another sub into this area, a couple more subs. We do have these guys heading south and these guys heading south. Now, those are going to be the long range subs that are going off the coast of Oz. I think these guys are the ones that are going to be setting off Noumea, the little closer ones, the short range subs. So, meanwhile, we are building up our forces in here. We're loading up and sending some supply to Batabob. These guys should unload and redeem. We'll probably make a cruiser task force to bombard Monado if I don't take it next turn. And we can probably push these guys further south as well. Lipitai has finished resizing everything. We got our planes on board this turn. So we will proceed to head south towards Palembang or CRB, Cameron Bay. And we will start loading up the invasion force for Palembang next turn. So we'll probably be invading Palembang within a week, maybe around Christmas. And then probably either right before or the first week of January, we will be touching down in Java. So once we take Batavia and Sorabeha, then I will proceed to take Miri in the north of Sarawak in North Borneo. I usually don't take Balakpakan, Sarakan, Miri, and all that until I get rid of the bases that he can fly B-17s out of easily. We will be trying to take to Cagayan at some point once we free up some more combat power. So, yeah, that's pretty much where we're looking at right now. So, once we take, no, you're pretty much empty. Once we take, Rabaul, a good chunk of these, a couple of these airfield units and a good chunk of these construction battalions will be heading south to Rabaul to help build up the Solomon Islands and that. We're moving on Moulmein. We're about, this turn, the air flotilla is blown up, so we're about 4 days out from having torpedoes in Bangkok. Once we get that, next turn, we will try to start reducing his air cover over Rangoon. And then we will start putting, like, maybe the first day or so, we will let this short where we don't fly into Rangoon, but we can shoot anything that we spot in here, like Sinka's minesweepers and stuff. That is the plan. A tanker up in Calcutta. Interesting. That must be from Zing it. No. Auckland, huh? X 101, nothing. yeah, so that's pretty much where we're at right now. We're gonna just start taking all these four, the Bismarck Sea, all these guys, take Shortlands, take Tulagi, take Ley, and start building up our forces that we want to build here. I have not decided if how far we're going to push. He's got me well spotted now, so we're just using these as a cover force, and then we'll probably pull back. I do have my tankers set up over here, so we can refuel if we need to. But we're looking pretty decent on fuel for right now. So, all right, guys, I will catch you all later.